Hello everyone, in this tutorial I am going to use extrude, which is the icon at the right side, and I am going to select extrude and on the displacement define we must define a plane, and the reference plane it appeared. I have used the front plane as a sketch plane, and the reference plane is a standard right, and we accept it. We select the sketch, and the sketch icons appeared here. Now I am going to make a rectangle up there, down there, and to exit the line you are going to select the pile, and I am going to change this one 120 and this one as 200 and this angle as 60. Now we have our triangle, and I am going to use the corner and select that line and that line, and we are going to select that line and that line and select that line and that line. Okay, now we are going to change the dimension to 20, 20 here, and the radius up there we are going to make it as 40. Now I am going to select the circle, and I am going to make a circle here. When it appear R means that that circle and that circle has the same radius, and select and make a circle here and select the pile and change the radius to 20 and this one as 50 and everything as it should be. So exit sketch, and it appeared default thickness of the sketch of extrude, and I'm going to change it as 100 or maybe 80, and this one it is blind, and it is midpoint, and it is up to surface. So everything is okay. Exit the extrude, and we are going to under application we are going to use Mechanica. And it appears mechanical model setup, and we have both structure and thermal, but we want a structure, and the default interface is bonded or free or contact, but we will bond it. Now we are going we have simulation icons and the force, pressure, pressure and another it is bearing load, and it is our constraint, and it is mirror, and springs, and so on. But for our model, we are going to define a material, and we are going to select that one, material assignment, and here under material we are going to select more, and I am going to use steel and press that materials in model and select UCO and UCO again. Now the material is defined, and I am going to use that strain, and I am going to select that surface and keep control key and select that surface, and I am going to use the clamp or fix, and you can see that they are fixed, and also translation are fixed too. Select UCO, and I am going to make a pressure on this side and make it 10 and change the measurement as megapascal UCO. Now everything is okay, defined, and I am going to select the simulation, and it appear a window, and under file I am going to select new static, and the name is as default analysis one as you can have it, and everything is okay, the constraint and load set, and select UCO and select the run. It appeared something that it was remove something accepted, and use interactive diagnostics. It opens a diagnostic report, and the run is completed, and use close and select the show results. And here I want to see the stresses in megapascal, and it is 1 meter, and okay and show. Now you can see that you have maximum 20 or 30 megapascal in this area as we suggested. Now I am going to insert result window, and it is analysis one open, and I am going to see the displacement in millimeter, okay and show, and it is 0.16 millimeter as displacement. UCO, we are going to insert result window and analysis, okay, and we are going to see the strain, and the strain is very low and it is accepted. And all those values are is low, and we are going to exit result, and if you want it you can save the result, and we are going back to our model, and we are going to select the planes and the axes to be we don't want show, and when you select it is hide, and we are going to under file or under file new, and we are going to select drawing and name it Uko, and I am going to use a A4 format for drawing and Uko. Now you have a front view, top view and right view, and I am going under annotation, annotate. I am going to use show model annotation, and I select that one. As you see, we have a lot of dimensions, and I am going to will show that one and that one. Cancel. Show the model. Select that one. And as you see, you have that radius, that diameter. That one. That one. That one. We are going to show that one. That one. That one is duplicated with that one, and I need to show I am selecting that one. No, I am selecting that one. Okay, and I am going to move that one, move that one, move that one, move that one, and delete that one. Okay, what I need, this is that length, or because of you have a 60 and 30, it is not so important, but I am going to select that one and mode. That one, it's necessary, that one, and move it, and this part show, and the radius here is that one and I don't need it. I need that one. Uko. Okay. Now you have all those dimensions and you go to under file. You can save it and then under publish you can make it as DVG and export, or you can print it, and it is another dimension when you want use it as when you want to send it to production, and you must make it as one of those formats for different type of CNC machine. And I am going to close the window. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.